All right, welcome to another how-to video from bluebutterflycreations.blogspot.com. This is a beginning video for a spiderweb layout, which you will see later on in my blogspot or on my YouTube account. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Versamark watermark stamp pad and pen with embossing powders and stamped images. So in front of me I have a 12 by 12 piece of black, and I'm using this just so I can show you samples. You can do this on any array of colors with any array of colored powders, stamps, or freehand drawings. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do some freehand first, and the size of the marker that you use is entirely up to you depending on what you're drawing. So where my layout is spider webs, I'm gonna just start in this corner and I'm gonna swirl my pen to create a spider web. Very simple. You may not exactly see how I'm drawing my spider web, and that's okay. You'll see it once I'm done for sure. So I'm just kind of swirling my pen around, creating marks that I want the powder to adhere to. Oops. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this piece of regular old printer paper. I'm going to slide it underneath that corner. And I've already put a fold into the paper so I can pour my extra powder back into my jar. And then I'm just going to sprinkle a healthy portion of powder across that area that I used. Okay, I'm going to pick up my paper. I'm just going to shake that powder around, and as you can see, it's starting to stick to wherever that marker colored across the paper. I'm just going to slowly shake it around so everything gets covered, and then I'm going to pour my extra off so it just kind of sits there. Alright, I'm going to pour my extra powder back into my jar because I think it tends to be a little expensive. It can range between $2 to $5, sometimes even $6 for a small jar, but the jar will last you a long time. Okay, so once my powder's on there, I've tapped off the extra. I'm going to take my heat gun, and this is just an embossing heat tool. You can also use a hair dryer to make this. I'm going to turn it on, and I'm keeping it slightly away from my paper. I'm about 2 inches up from my paper. I'm testing very gently because it does get very hot. And as you can see, if you're doing this while I'm doing it, as you're moving it across, you'll notice that the white in the powder I'm using is getting very bold against the black, which means that it is melting. I'm going evenly back and forth across my design. I went vertical, now I'm going horizontal, just so I can make sure it's all covered. I'm going back again, and there is the freehand spider web. Now, using the Versamark ink pad, I'm going to stamp this image of a spider on a web with the ink. And this is a very moist ink. It stays moist for a long time. And I'm going to stamp my image. Where do I want it? I want to put it down the corner here. Okay. So I stamp my image. And for fun, I'm going to take my marker back. And I'm going to draw this big line all the way down to where the spider is. Again, I'm going to put my paper underneath I'm going to take my embossing powder. I'm going to sprinkle a generous amount right on there. I'm going to shake it around so I make sure everything gets covered, turning the paper as needed. Okay, then I'm going to guide the extra off. I'm gonna, just a gentle tap, make sure I got all that extra out of the way. I'm going to take care of my extra powder first by pouring it back into my jar. Okay. I'm going to take my heat tool again. I've got it on. And I'm about an inch to two away from the paper, slowly moving down the powder. And as I do, I can see the changes. It's becoming a deeper, more rich white. I'm going around my spider very gently with the heat. Back up, making sure everything's locked in. And down again. I'm going to turn off my tool and set it aside. And there you have it. There is a image using a stamp in VersaMark and a freehand with the VersaMark pen using embossing powder and a heat tool. Again, for a heat tool, if you don't want to buy a heat tool specifically, you can use a hair dryer if you have it, and hair dryers tend to be less expensive. I suggest if you use the hair dryer, use it on a lower heat. And thank you for joining me on this how-to. Please check out my blogspot. It's blue without the butterflycreations.blogspot.com for more information and a more in-depth tips and techniques for dry powder embossing.